I can't think nothing better than spending my day with you. My life's sunny and better, girl, when I'm with you.
Okay, today's business spotlight is on Vanity and Beyond, your number one shop to get cuticle oils. You can get your teeth whitened. You can get a custom set of press-on nails made, as well as shoes and clothes made and shipped straight from Italy to your door with no taxes and no shipping fees on all the shoes.
If you are not new to the channel, I see you. Thank you for coming back. And if you are new, welcome and thanks for showing up. Let's begin. Okay, y'all, so before we really get started into today's story, I just want to let y'all know that this video is going to be all over the place, child. Yes, all over the place. And it's okay because we're not really here for the video, right? We here for the stories. You know, the video is just a little something to look at, a little entertainment while I tell the story. So it's okay. And it was a little difficult to actually do the nail sets without having the nail out of frame. So we're going to be a little bit out of frame on this video as well, but we good. We're going to get through this today and we just going to do the story. So let's flip and let's begin. Okay. So today I am going to be telling y'all the backstory from my last story. The time that I got whooped twice in one day. So I had told you all towards the end of that I will be coming back to give you all the backstory. Or I don't know, maybe I said it on my podcast. Because if you guys don't know, I also have a podcast. So make sure y'all go follow and support the podcast. I do story time, which is pretty much over here on YouTube. It's called Nails and Tales. But on my podcast, it's called Story Time. It's called Back Down Memory Lane. I'm sorry. On here, it's called Story Time. And I also do celebrity, you know, news and drama. And I'm about to start a new segment called Dear Diary. And people are sending in their email stories. And, you know, I'm kind of reading the stories and whatnot. And we talk about it, you know, get into it. So, anyways, if you all have not followed my podcast yet or don't know anything about it, go ahead and do that and follow my podcast at Spilling All the Beans. And you can find me on Anchor FM, Spotify, Google Podcasts, Breaker, Pocket Cast, Radio Public, Overcast, multiple other sites. Anywhere pretty much you can hear podcasting. Just look up Spilling All the Beans. I'm there. But anyways, now in today's video, I am going to be telling y'all the backstory from the time I got whooped twice in one day. And this story basically is explaining why we fell out with the such and such kids. Because, you know, I told y'all everybody got a name and those kids are called the such and such kids. And, you know, we're going to start the story with earlier that day and what led up to things. So, you know, earlier that day, me, my cousin G, and his friend, which is our friend. I don't know why I always say his friend, but our friend, D. We was all outside, you know what I'm saying? Hanging out in the vacant lot or whatever. And it was kind of like not too late, but slightly early. You know, like maybe 11, 12, noon, 11 in the morning. And a lot of kids had not came outside yet. So, you know, we was kind of bored waiting on the other kids to come outside. So my cousin G, he was like, man, it's bored, y'all. Y'all want to go to Jules? Now, for those of you who have not heard this story on my podcast yet, when my cousin G asks, like, y'all want to go to Jules or y'all want to go to Walgreens or, you know, one of the local stores like that, we're basically going to go and do some five-finger discounting, do some stealing. Now, don't judge us, okay, because everybody was kids. Y'all all stole once. And if you haven't, good for you, good for you. But anyways, you know, that means we were going to go steal. So he like, man, y'all want to go to Jules? And I'm like, you know, thinking to myself like, shoot, yeah, why not? You know, I ain't got no money right now and whatnot, you know, but I do want some candy. And these are the only stores where we can go in and kind of do some stealing in our little bags or whatnot and go. So we all went to our houses and got the little bags that we were going to use to put our candy and stuff in. And we met back up in the vacant alley. So, you know, I had my little fanny pack, you know, for those who remember the fanny packs. I had my little fanny pack, my little Mickey Mouse fanny pack. And G and D had their little, like, little drawstring baggies. You know, I don't know if y'all, they probably still do come out too. Like the little, it's like, y'all know the drawstring bags, but they like book bag, backpacks, or you can wear it on one arm. So anyways, they had those bags. So we on our way, we head up to Jules or whatnot, so we can go ahead and do our little stealing. And in Jules, like Jules, Walgreens, those type of stores, they don't have it anymore. But back then, they used to have in their candy aisles, it was these big, well, not super big, but like nice little small individual containers that was all stuck together. And in each container was some type of candy or raisins, peanuts, things like that. You know, loose candy, gum, bubble gum, shit like that. And you had to lift up the top. Oh, excuse me, guys. You had to lift up the top to kind of scoop the candy out or whatever into your clear bag. You weigh the bag up, take it up to the front, and you pay for it. Well, of course, we didn't do that. We opened up the little cases, and we would take out the candy that we want, hands full at a time, stuffing it in our bags. Now, I don't know if security was already watching us this day, because my cousin G was known for stealing a lot. So he probably was already hot. You know what I'm saying? So when they seen us probably come in the door, they probably already was alerting security to keep an eye on us. I don't know. Or be it that somebody that worked there kind of probably walked past the aisle and seen us stealing and stuff. But however it goes, we were seen by security. So as we got through packing the little candy in our bags and stuff, we getting ready to head out the door. Now, before we leave out, security come from out of nowhere and was like, hey, hold on. You know, like, where y'all going, basically? And my cousin G turned around to see, you know, who was saying something and seen it was security. Boom. He jets out the door, right? Soon as he jets out the door, D run his butt out the door right after him. Yeah, so if y'all haven't noticed yet, your girl stood there. Froze in fear. Yes, I stood there. I don't know. It was like my mind was like, run with them because they running. But then, I don't know, I guess in my head I was feeling like, because I was the last one, that if I ran, he was going to catch me anyway. Like, I don't know what was going on in my mind, but nevertheless, I didn't run. I stood my stupid self there. So the security come up, you know, whatever. He was like, let me see your little pouch, your bag or whatever. And I'm, you know, being a kid, being me, why I need to show you my bag and da-da-da. So he was like, you know, basically still telling me to take the bag off and telling me basically he didn't seen us, that we were stealing, yada, yada. And I'm like, I wasn't stealing. What were you talking about? I wasn't stealing this and that. So he, you know, end up just clipping the little pouch off my sack, clip it, grab the little pouch or whatever. So, you know me, I'm like, what you doing? You can't just grab my bag. You can't just go on my stuff like that. Yada, yada, yada. So I do unzip the bag, not paying my last, barking and talking shit, no attention. He unzips my bag, boom, dump the candy all out on the counter. So I'm sitting here looking stupid like, wow, okay, I'm caught now, so what's next? Of course, as we all know, when we young and we get caught, our mind goes so fast ahead of itself, we still find ourselves lying. So he like, well, what's this? You know what I'm saying? Was you planning on buying this candy? You know, well, what's all this? So me being stupid, I'm like, that's my candy. I been had that candy. I came in the store with that candy. And, you know, he basically looking at me like, man, you know, it's over with. You might as well give it up. You're caught, yada, yada. So he like, come on, we come on off to the back. And I'm like, nah, I don't have to go to the back. I don't have to go nowhere. And he like, look, basically, you can either come to the back and we can call your mama. And so, or somebody, you know, to come up here and come and get you and, you know, find out what's going on. Or we can call the police. Then basically my options. So I'm sitting here looking stupid. I'm like, oh my God, I already know. If my mama come up to this store and find out that I've been stealing, I am going to get my butt whooped from here to Kingdom Come. Okay. All the way to the house. And need I imagine we about 3-4 blocks up. You know what I'm saying? So I'm like, I start crying and I'm trying to plead with him like, well, I'll put it back. You know, like, can I just put it back? I'm crying or whatever. And he like, well, you know, nah, it's too late for all of that. And, you know, and then pretty much your friends then ran off and left you, and, you know, left you here to take the blame, yada, yada. So he like, nah, come on, we come on to the back and we'll just call your mama. You know, basically like he giving me a out instead of calling the police, you know. Like, nah, come on. So I don't know what it was, but my legs locked out of place. And instead, you know, to get ready to walk with him. But my man was just like, just run. You know what I'm saying? Like, how was they going to find who you are? You know what I mean? Like, all these kids in the neighborhood, how they going to find out who you are, you know, to tell on you? So I was like, forget it. I turned, instead of walking with him towards him, you know, to his little office, I turned around and ran my butt out the door. So I'm running. I'm getting across the street. I didn't cross the whole. It's a big old whole vacant field where it once was a store, but it got tore down, burnt up and everything. So now it's just an empty field. So I'm running through the field. I mean, when I say full throttle, y'all, I'm tagged, but I don't know what it was. I could not stop running because it just felt like this man was on my heels. I don't know what it was, but I was getting it. And as I'm getting it across the field or whatever, I'm going diagonal instead of, you know, straight up going towards my house. I'm going more diagonal, which will be leading me towards my grandma's way. So I'm jetting, I'm getting it or whatever, finally making more, you know, towards my grandma way and a further away from the store. And I just couldn't do it no more. I start slowing down. I'm tagged. I'm thinking to myself, like, if this man still running behind me, forget it. I'm just caught. So as I stop, slow down, and look behind me, realize, child, well, nobody running with me but the wind. But I was happy, like, woo. My legs shaking. I'm tagged. I'm just like, man, I'm feeling real jelly like it. Like, oh my God, I just ran for my life. Like somebody just tried to kidnap me. So I head towards, you know, going back to up from, you know, because like I said, we stayed around the corner from my granny, like two blocks up. So I'm going in a direction towards my granny house. But, you know, I shift directions and go ahead and go towards our house because I'm knowing in my head, D&G is back at the house. You know what I'm saying? Probably waiting to see what happened, you know, if I'm pulling up with the police, you know what I'm saying? Because they didn't caught, you know, I got caught. And I'm guessing like, okay, they got to still be sitting on the block waiting to see the outcome if I'm snitched. So I get back over there on the block. These fools sitting on the little mattress, you know, I told y'all that we all flip on and chill on. They sitting out there, whatever, with eating their little candy and chilling out. I come walking up like, hey, man, y'all bogus. Why y'all run and leave me? Yada, yada. You know what I'm saying? And my cousin G, like, he laughing at me as I come up. He's shaking his head like, bruh, you about to stop coming with us to go do stuff because you're going to end up getting us caught, man. Like, why didn't you run with us? Why would you just stand there? So, you know me, I'm thinking to myself, like, dude, I was scared. What did you expect? Like, we ain't never been caught, even though he do it more than we do. But I'm thinking to myself, like, we ain't never been caught, so I was scared. So, you know, we like, forget it. We brush it all off. You know what I'm saying? They give me a little bit of their candy and stuff, you know, because I ain't got no more candy now. So they give me sharing their candy with me. So my cousin G like, man, come on, let's go to the park or whatever, you know, because the such and such kids, they across the street. So we's going to go play. We make it to the park to go hang out. Now, you know, the little seesaws, one of our little friends and the such and such kid's sister, you know, was playing on the little seesaw. Now, our friend is a little bit skinnier than this, you know, the other girl. So it was kind of a little difficult at times for her to flop the seesaw down to flop the other girl back up. And my cousin G caught himself trying to help our friend out. And he jumped on the pole part of the seesaw, which made the other girl flop up and over the seesaw. So she ended up hitting her head, you know, on the pole, fell on the floor in the wood chucks, everything, child. So she get up, she snapping off or whatever. She got her fist balled up. She walking up to my cousin talking smack or whatever because he made her fall. So she mad now. And I guess in that moment, it didn't catch the attention of her brothers who was on the other side of the park on the actual equipment playing. So, you know, she kind of like walked was turning around to walk off, but she was still talking smack. So my cousin G started talking smack too, or whatever, called out her name, like, B, whatever, you doing the most, da da da, whatever he was saying. So the girl turned back around, you know, ready to fight. So she like, what? Man, what you call me? What you say? She walks back up. So at this point, my cousin G is the type of person where he like, look, don't walk up on me more than once. If I try to blow it off the first time, don't keep walking up on me. So this time he grabs her. Well, not grab her, but he like put his hand kind of around her throat and pushed her so that, you know, she can back up off him. Oh, it was over with from there. Here come the brothers and them come running to the other side or whatever because they heard him. And her from the, you know, the second time arguing. So here they come off on the other side. Boom. He walk up on my cousin G. They snapping off. They talking smack. My cousin G like, you know, whatever is whatever. And you ain't gonna keep walking up on my face either. Yada, yada, yada. So the brother end up pushing my cousin G. And my cousin G kind of tumbled back a little bit. And, you know, like it was a little log right there. You know, he tumbled back over. So my cousin G, boom, he get up, they connect, bow, he hit him and dude get the fighting or whatever. So everybody else, as you know, all of us start the fighting or whatever and rumbling. And it's these, you know, little gangster dudes or whatever that was at the park who came over to stop us from fighting. Oh, so, you know, we get up and we go on our separate ways or whatever to go around the corner to our, you know, location and whatnot. And my cousin G just like, you know, we done playing with them. We ain't messing with them no more. It is what it is. We ain't got to be friends with them. Da, da, da. So, you know, I'm just like, okay, hey, whatever. We ain't cool with them no more. And, you know, so that's kind of how the beef got started, you guys. Led up to us not messing with the kids no more. That caused the other fight in my last video. So that's why it was what it was. It was kind of an on-site thing, you know, from our last fight. But anyways, I hope you guys like the story today. Comment down below. Please like, subscribe. Like, come on here. Help me out, you guys. I mean, like, I know I'm new to all of this YouTube stuff, but help me out, you know, get your girl up there a little bit. And I promise to bring y'all more stories to tell. But anyways, I also hope y'all like these nails on this video as well, honey, because it was very difficult doing them on this video. But thank you guys for watching. I hope you come back on the next one. Again, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Please subscribe. And I'll see you guys on the next video. Bye.